So, Sean, the news that you have is that you actually got the vaccine.
I mean, if
the
you want...
The cure.
Yeah, well...
The cure-all.
And the thing is, the vaccine is not available to everyone. And,
right.
And they said that in this long email that, you know, it's all blah, 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 blah. So I don't want to read it. But the key points that I got
I had to sign something at the end of it.
If you're signing up for this, you know, because I'm in what they call an elite class of the first variety. And
the 1%?
I don't know. Not financially, but I mean, health-wise, yes.
Oh.
I'm stronger now than 99% of the people out
Humans?
There. That's right. If we had to fight COVID mano a mano, then...
You're going
to
punch it in the face.
I'm going to hold my own. Yeah.
Yeah. At least until you get that second dose.
Yeah, but I mean, still.
Yeah.
But still, I don't think I really need the second one. Or no? If I get second, then why not? I should get a third one. I'm just going to keep it going, kind of like the roids. Yeah, so I mean, not... Everybody is even brave and strong enough and capable. Their bodies can't handle it yet. That's why secretly they can't distribute the vaccine to the public and everything. They need the most elite people to make sure that if the strongest can get it and they survive, then society will be fine. Because really, only the strong survive. But anyway,
yeah, I think that's how they actually do the test. Is that's where right. they test it on the strongest of us.
Yes.
That way, if any of them died, then we for sure know it's bad.
Exactly, because if they tested it on the weakest of us, like, well,
I mean,
if
that's
they
not died, a good litmus test.
They're gonna pass away anyway because they're weak.
Yeah, that's it's
you know, survival of the fittest. You know what I mean?
It's just science.
Exactly. There's a lot of science going on right now. So
yeah.
And I'm kind of like a Captain America type at this point, where science is going on in and around my body, and I have emerged
2 feet taller.
I feel taller. I filled out my suit jacket a little bit more. It's a little bit tighter.
It's
now.
A little bit more. I mean,
and that's only the first injection, bro.
Dang. Exactly. Are you gonna come back a full Chris Evans,
dude? I can't be for sure, but I think I'm the real life Captain America. But there's no way to know for sure. They did say that when we were talking before I got pokey poked, there's going to be some side effects. You know, they said that, you know, your deltoids could swell up to like up to 12% larger. Mm-hmm. There's going to be some of your reproductive organs are going to be engorged and they will never get smaller again. There's gonna be like this
constant boners.
No.
Gonna be
no, even flaccid and enlarged. Yeah, sorry. I don't want to go into that. I'm trying to stay scientific, but
my bad.
Yeah, so it's bigger
and you're also going to encounter more people, more red skeletons in your life than
red skulls
before. Yeah.
And then also they said something about like this pheromone. So if I'm walking around in public and there's, you know, young fertile ladies, they potentially, science hasn't been around. I mean, the vaccine hasn't been around long enough to prove this theory wrong, but they could be impregnated just by me walking by them.
Oh, wow.
If they're ovulating, obviously.
That's science.
So I got to be careful. So now I have to like socially distance unless I want to get them pregnant. Like
you have to socially distance for just child support.
Exactly.
Reasons.
Yeah.
Like you don't want to be paying those additional
payments. I mean, I imagine whenever I like, you know, when I fill out completely and I really am,
when the second dose comes
and
in
and I get fitted for like the shield and stuff I find my Falcon like sidekick and stuff and shield and like Nick Fury sends me an email. I imagine he's savvy now, so he'll probably like send an email or whatever.
You're probably on the short list.
Yeah, but anyway,
right now.
Yeah, I mean, but I'm on the peak 1%. I mean, I'm peak physical condition.
And you had just gotten this today.
Yeah. Whoa. I already feel it. Yeah, I'm only getting stronger.
Yeah. The Monster Energy drink is
this is just my regular water now. Regular.
You don't even need it.
I have to be hydrated by something extreme as this.
Oh yeah, the energy that your Captain America vaccine has given you,
bestowed upon me because of my worthiness,
is you drink Monsters now to go to sleep because
this is my sleepy time tea.
Yeah, this is your chamomile Monster. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So
I still drink it from the can because I don't like to steep it because it's kind of. There's nothing.
It's an ordeal. Yeah. And you want it cold. You want the carbs.
I've only had this vaccine for a couple hours. I still got. I mean, I'm not perfect. I'm only 99% perfect.
Yeah.
No.
Well, this is, you know what? I will say this. Overall, the literature that I've read, I haven't heard any of this stuff. Nobody's talking about it.
Nobody's talking about it because I think the elite, there's certain people in the elite sector.
Which you're part of now.
Which are now that you've gotten the vaccine. I've been inducted into the you know, Science Hall of Fame.
The inner circle.
Yeah, I'm part of it now. And I want to break down barriers. You know, I'm not going to be one of these like role models that is going to like keep secrets away from the people. I'm a man of the people, for the people. I mean, if I'm going to be Captain America, like, I mean, I'm all about that freedom, baby. Yeah. I need to really represent the people and the people that I'm going to be fighting Hydra for.
So when you got to, like, how did this happen? Did you get to choose between the Pfizer and the Moderna? Were you like, one Pfizer, please?
So yeah. There's you show up and you can either stand in one line or another line.
Okay. So there was two lines.
Yeah.
Was one coming and the other going, or was, did one just have a large P and then the other one had another M?
Well, the thing is, no, there wasn't really anything like,
I'm not going in the pussy line. I'm in the man line.
Now that I'm thinking about it, there was like one that was going into the medical facility that was quite lengthy. And a lot of people that looked like they had to like sign in like paperwork and then like wait in a specific area. And I was like, I'm not about that. Yeah. And then there was like another one that was like pretty much a line that was pretty much non-existent. There was just one guy like waiting with like it was like some kind of like clipboard or something.
Okay.
And I was like, oh, there's obviously like Pfizer or Moderna. I gotta choose between. I was like, I'm not gonna wait with these chumps. I'm part of the 1% now. Like, these people are still living in the 99 world. I was like, I'm embracing my future early.
Yeah.
So I approached this guy and it was kind of like off to the side more of the building.
Okay.
Like, it was like a guy, yeah, by himself. No, and I cut straight to the front of the line.
Nice.
Nobody else was there.
Nice.
And I was like, hey, how's it going? And he's like, it's good. Are you here for the stuff? And I was like, yeah, I'm here for the stuff. And he kind of gave me like a wink. And I was like,
oh,
I was like, I've never been part of the 1% before. Like, I'm thinking all this.
You're nervous.
I was like, yeah. I was like, I don't want to say something that makes me seem like a weak guy or something. I was like, no. I'm just going to kind of like adapt to my situation, you know?
And you don't want to ask too many questions because you know you're there for it. You're there for it.
We know all that.
How did exactly this?
That's what he said. And he's like, so you're ready for it right now? And I was like, ready for it.
Question.
Yeah.
What did this man look like? Did he have a white coat?
He was kind of like a trendier looking guy, you know.
Oh,
he was very fashion forward, so he had a very like long, what looked like a kind of like unkempt beard, kind of.
Okay.
Actually, he had a suit jacket, kind of like this one.
Nice.
And he had like a scarf around, and he must have like recently come from the grocery store or something because he had his like shopping cart like right off to the side. I mean, he must have
classic
come
across, vaccine worker.
Come across, yeah, I like it. Across like a lot of like bargains because he had a lot of like random stuff in there. But you know, he's part of the 1%, so he knows his way around a bargain probably.
Okay, yeah, you know, okay.
Most for his money.
Yeah.
So he like pulled out a syringe like ready to go from.
From his jacket. Yeah. He was just gonna give it to you right then and there.
Yeah.
And then
he got his like, you know, his little like thing to tie it by arm.
Yeah.
You know, because he's gonna like help me out. And then he's like, Well, it's I only take cash. I'm like, oh yeah, because I'm not gonna ask stupid questions like, oh, I thought I didn't have to pay for this. So.
Yeah, you had to sign you already had to sign it that you thought it was being provided by the company that you work for. Mm-hmm.
And so I gave him $200.
Yeah.
$200.
$200.
Yeah. He asked for a 2-spot. So, and I wasn't gonna back down because I was like, I'm going to make so much money once I'm vaccinated in Captain America. Like, I'll be totally fine.
So you went in thinking that you're going to come out as a Captain America. You had that expectation.
Okay, well, I knew I already have really strong antibodies.
Okay.
And if I develop more antibodies, I'm just going to get taller and stronger and basically like invincible the way Captain America is.
Okay.
So I kind of bridged the gap a little bit. I jumped from A to C, but B was a very short distance.
Okay.
So anyway, right. I gave him the cash money and then he was tying up my arm and he's like, all right. And he like flicks and he's like, here you go. And he's like, and he started walking. I was like, wait, this is my first dose. He's like, oh, this is your first time? I was like, yeah, first dose for the vaccine. He's like, whatever you want to call it. And I was like, I don't know if this is Moderna or Pfizer anymore. But I was just like, I'm not going to ask like dumb bitch questions. I was like, I'll figure out my paperwork later. They'll probably just email me something. I was like, this is very routine for them.
Yeah. And you
brand
didn't have
new
to,
for me.
Yeah. You didn't have to fill anything out at this point. That's nice.
Learning. Yeah. So I was like, yeah, it's my first dose, first time. I was like, can you, if you could just like, help me with this, that would be great. He's like, yeah, sure. So he took the needle and he stuck me. And then I fell asleep in the alley for about 5 or 6 hours.
Okay.
I woke up not feeling very good, which is kind of normal.
Whenever. So during that time that you were kind of down, was there, before you like went to sleep, I guess,
I was like kind of like in hibernation. I was like hibernating and like seeing smells and colors, had smells. And
how was that portion of the vaccination?
No, you know, Chris Evans never explains what happens on the inside of the pod. We only see what happens on the outside.
And you went podless this time.
Yeah, yeah. There's no pod. I mean, that was like the 50s or something.
Well, that's 40s. That's also a movie. We're in the real life where everything comes through a vaccine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, yeah, they don't tell you that, you start to like feel like a little loopy and dizzy and you start to kind of, I don't know, like some people would say like hallucinate a little bit.
Okay.
And then you start to kind of feel sick to your stomach.
Did you feel warm, fuzzy all over and just constantly feeling like the world was one and you were with it?
Like kind of. And then I felt like I was going to throw up and then I passed out.
Okay.
Because I mean, my body was going through a lot of changes.
Okay.
So I wasn't ready for it.
Hmm.
And yeah. And then.
You had to build that muscle.
That's right. And then I woke up and then. And my wallet was gone, but I was like, oh, they probably needed to get my ID and like my social security card or whatever, you know. I was like everything's like, I had my phone on me still, so I was like, everything's electronic, I got Apple Pay, baby, like I don't need anything in my wallet, that's old school. Uh-huh. Driver's license is important, but I was like, nah, I was like, I don't even need a car, I can run so fast.
So I started running
and then I realized I was still tied up and my arm was like asleep, so I had to do that. And then but then I was like, oh, yeah, I drove here. So I probably need to bring my car back. Yeah. And I was like, probably driving without a license isn't okay. But I was like, I'm in the 1% now. Yep. And then got home, started to feel sick to my stomach again, passed out. And then you came over.
Okay.
Yeah.
What a experience. And now you're just jazzed.
And now
you're just a full CA. Now,
yeah. I feel like I really hit like a low point earlier today. But now I feel like... $1 million because I'm back to, I feel great.
Now, do you feel like you have just a unquenchable need to now have the vaccination constantly?
Oh, dude, I need to go back and do that again.
You need to find that technician.
Exactly. Like, I mean, because I'm in that elite class, Captain America type, I was like a real, like, a hero. And if you're a woman, you'd be a heroine.
Yeah,
but why am I thinking about heroin right now?
I don't know. No one dropped that word.
I don't know. Why do I want heroin? I don't know. Sex, drugs, rock and roll, though.
Sex, drugs, rock and roll.
No, but I got the vaccine, and now I want to do heroin. But I guess my body can handle it.
your body can probably handle heroin. Now that you know that you can have the vaccine and not have anything bad happen to you whatsoever, other than your wallet gets stolen.
Wait.
I think we've really discovered quite a bit. Are you rethinking which line you should have stood in?
My head. Sorry, I've got a really bad headache right now.
Okay.
Yeah, because I mean, like everybody else that I ran into after, like coworkers and stuff, they have the cards and people taking pictures. And it's like the proof of vaccination. And I didn't get that. I just kind of like, my body felt like it was dying. Unless I got more vaccine.
Oh, dang. Man, Sean, I don't know if you went... I don't think you used enough science when getting your vaccine.
I think I had a bad vaccine. I think...
You might have to come back and get more.
Maybe the medical professional switched out Moderna vaccine for heroin.
Oh, no!
Now that I'm thinking about it...
Did any of your other coworkers talk about dropping 200 on a...
No, they didn't. No. None of them passed out in the alley.
Oh, wow. You definitely got something different than them.
Maybe it's like an elite version of the
elite. Sean. Oh, buddy boy.
I'm going to be fine.
Are you?
If I get more of that part.
You get more vaccine. Well, here's Sean. Good news. The CDC recommends you get at least one more.
Oh, thank God.
But I think I've
never felt so good.
Okay, bad news?
Yeah.
I think you have to wait like 60 days? 2 weeks, I think, is what it is. You're going to try and find that guy after the podcast, aren't you?
But I mean, yeah. All right. So anyway, did Sean get vaccinated or did he have his first encounter with heroin or maybe, I don't know, methamphetamine? Whatever it was. It was in a vial. It costed $200. I got robbed and I felt terrible, but I need to do it again.
That's all you know.
So it probably was Pfizer.
You know, I'm a Moderna man.
Yeah.
Well.